Hi, John here. I'm just having steak, mushroom, tomato, and kinnas over here for dinner. Well, some nice kinnas. I had two today. And what else am I having? That and some fried bread and some oranges over there and fried bread in here. I got some fried bread in here. From Toby's. And I've already eaten most of them. Oh, I only got a bit more left. So much better, anyway. But, that's my dinner. I just finished cooking the mushrooms. I'll get some more tomorrow. I'll get some more mushrooms. I love my mushrooms at dinner. So I'm just, put this over here. And just tell you what's going on. Now, I've just made a video of Morris Baker from Baker Street in Taheke. It's a new street called Baker Street, and there's a song about Baker Street that's well known, and so he's going to go boom boom boom. That's what how Pody Harris explained his Ngāti Kuri tūpuna, hongihika. He says boom boom boom, so that's the musket law, boom boom boom. And whereas Morris Baker is not saying boom boom boom, he's using his pen and his paper and his titles to fix up his British titles with Moira Hoffman Russell from Taheke region of his ancestor Huri Tikuri. Now, I've been having a good talk with Morris Lobo Baker and his wife Marianne Hiramaya from Ahipara. Hiramaya is a son of Huri Tikuri. So there's a connection there. And Huri Tikuri's father, Rameka, is at the back of Morris's house, which just happens to be the first Arata church that grew out of the Methodist church at Mangungu Methodist Church Mission House, where these British settlers came straight in from Britain, straight into the Hokianga Harbour, and they had pre-bought the land at Whirinaki on Huri Tikuri's ancestral lands of his ancestor Rameka. So Rameka was in the Wesleyan Church in Whirinaki, so he was very well known to the British settlers, Russell, John Russell, and Busby, Busby family, James Busby and their family there, and they settled in that area, and Moira Hoffman Russell just happens to be a little girl who lived there and knows everything about Rāwini and this place called Manungu, where the mission houses and her ancestors made a commercial contract through her Navy family with Huri Tikuri and his British title. He sold the lands to these families illegally and legitimate through King William IV and previous to that King George IV, 1820 to 1830, in Tirawaikato Whare Here Here Moriori title in Edinburgh Magistrate Court, Scotland. Those titles were sold to forth New Zealand and Pacific Islands. I sold back then. So, Rewhere from Manukau succeeded to Te Waikato under King William IV, 1830 to 1837 period. And Te Waikato was the seller of his own ancestors' lands to Rogan on the title in Awaroa Native Magistrate Court, Helensville, and the Waikato area of South Manukau Harbour at Awhitu. The Menhinics from Taheke stole that title and that marae, the Manukau marae, off Rewherewha Manukau and bodged up the titles in the Kaipara Harbour. And that's where the problem lies, because the Ratana Church, before it went down to Ratana, was already set up out of this Methodist Church title, British title. That's where it started from. So that's all I want to say for this video for now. I'm going to have my dinner and I'm going to show you my kina. My kina. Lovely kina. That's beautiful. I'm going to break one open in the steak. Cut the kina, sheet action, cut with a knife, through, and oh, I broke it in bits. I made a mess of it. I'll show you a bit of the roe that come out of it, and I get my little bread, and that's the part, that's a nice bit there, the roe of the kina, there, come out of there, okay, show you. I'll show my girlfriend in Whippy, and I have some mushrooms. Mushrooms. Make me a coffee. Make a hot coffee. Hot coffee. It's 10 o'clock at night. And I'm still up late. Coffee. Milk. Coffee. I don't usually drink out of a bottle of milk when there's people around. I don't do that, but I do by myself because I need. So I have some tomato. Bread. Only got a bit of Toby's bread left, see? muffled in there. I'm just showing my girlfriend how I eat when I on the move. I'll be going to live in Philippines with my girlfriend up the back of La Castelli. That's out of Bacolod. Back rock. Right in a nice quiet place. Very quiet. I talked to her kids today. They call me Daddy John. Daddy John. Not King John, Daddy John. They call me King John in England, Britain, UK. Yummy. I do put a bit of sugar in my coffee. Not much. Just a little. Got a bit of steak in here, but I should cut it up. That was a mushroom fry. A fry in margarine. Not butter, I'm gone right off butter. I'll stick to margarine for now. Seems to be alright, part of the health. Certification, margarine's okay. I like the water of the tinner because it cleans you out. It's good for cleaning your stomach out. Now, peanuts. I'm going back and get some more tomorrow. Because I love peanuts. It's beautiful. I eat all of it inside. There. Darling, I'm eating. In my coffee. With milk and sugar. And I drink the water. Because it's got iodine in it. Iodine. That's one thing I've gone. I'll go get quinoa number two. Make sure I don't get quinoa. I ate all the quinoa. Number two quinoa. Cut it up here. Then with a knife. I cut it open with a knife. Try to make a clean cut. Stretch through. This time, try and make a better cut. Make it a little better. Just go through and boom, boom, boom. That's what Cody House said. Boom, boom. Mushrooms. Soft, yes it is. It's very soft. Superb. Absolutely. Just so, lovely biscuit. Snacks. I love snacks. Chocolate snack biscuit. Okay. Drink the water. Yeah, I've done. Kidneys are like clean you out. They're very good, better than medicines and doctors. You see that the row inside. A live dinner. They eat seaweed and good for you. Healthy. That's what it looks like. Snack biscuit. I didn't pack it for this snack biscuit. They're only $2. In my shop up here. Put a bit of margarine on. The steak is soft. This steak. I wouldn't normally eat out of a pot. But since I'm a bachelor, just one dish less to wash. The soup of the mushroom. It's nice. You can put flour in, just thicken it up. Quite a lot of it, I guess. I like it just like that, with the mushroom cooked in margarine. Without the flour. Drink the water. It cleans your whole system out, the water. Good for your heart, good for your heart, and kidneys are real lovely. Cheers. Yeah. Darling, show your customers that eating kidneys is good for you. Blood pressure. Up you go. My shop up here, they have nice steak. Beautiful. They have good food. From New World. Oh. Countdown, I think. New World, I think. I'm not sure. Magic Mall. I saw a big box, just big, full of mushrooms, $5. Big truck. $5. I'm gonna get it tomorrow. See, I'm having dinner late. I had a long run today. Just doing video. I spent all morning looking for fishing. And when I saw the cleaners, I used to die. That's the cleaners. And carried them in. Under my sack. Put them in the fresh water. Really enjoying my dinner because I just love dinners and fish eggs. Snacker. Fish eggs. That's what it's gonna look like. Click for this. Muscle. You may enjoy my dinner. 11 o'clock at night. I'm still up at midnight. It's 6 p.m. in the evening. In the Philippines. They can really sing. I'd love to go there and sing. Get my tall string up again. Start singing. America got talent. No. Britain's got talent. Britain's got talent. Or it'll be Thailand's got talent. I'll just make our own show. I'm going to use it. Talent got talent. Oh, my last dinner, my second dinner, and I'm full. That's all I needed, 2 dinners. Three more for tomorrow. 3 dinners left for tomorrow. Then an orange after my pudding. I used to have orange with a snack biscuit. What's that in there? Get it for it. Put my 3 dinners for tomorrow. The fridge. Pot in the face. the shells away. Have another biscuit. This is my dinner. That's all. Not for long. Go to flipping. Nice hair. Your hair? Nice hair. Nice woman. Nice clothes. Nice attitude. Not out, not in. Yeah, what do you got? All of that. And a nice glass. I'm not on meditation. Not on meditation, but dreaded meditation. I'm going to make sure meditation does not get in my system again. You will kill off meditation. Know that natural. So that's the next. Monsanto, that's the marijuana off them, I'm going to boot them off the marijuana. That's God's gift for us. Growing on the native's lands, the native gets their land back. And I can't find any way else to get it back. Only the king's way, the king of the Lord, the king will finish things. Yeah, I just wipe my table and get back to work. Another little tea. Well, I've got a bit of untidy house, but hey, I work more than I clean my house. I'm doing some videos, and upload it. Okay, I've got that one. Finish and upload.
Sorry, while I'm here, I'm happy to say I have been to get fish heads and came back with kennels. My kennels for lunch and my braids thrives on kennels to clear my blood and make me beautiful and shiny clean. Yeah. And I got some
it works.
British Royal Navy family settled here on the commercial landowner, Paramount Chief Hori Pikuri's ancestral native land in Mangungu, where the 1840 Treaty of Waitangi was really signed, where the British Royal family sailed in with the Russell families and Busby families, and my friend Moira Hoffman Russell is certified truthfully an account of this area where she lived all her life, and notably Whirunaki lowland. They bought from Hori Pikuri in a 360 degree area of his lands, British titles under his this original 1840 Treaty of Waitangi British title document, and not the New South Wales New Zealand 1840 Treaty of Waitangi document at Waitangi Marae, where the ship of Admiralty is the New Zealand Navy usurped and faked the British Royal Navy jurisdiction at Mangungu Mission House and Methodist Church on Hori Pikuri and his Tahiki Marae Native Magistrate Court, British memorialised King William IV Crown Land Patent Native Land sold by its native Paramount Chief Hori Pikuri to the Busby and Russell families in Whirunaki under British immigration laws on these lands fixed to this date, wow. Treaty of Waitangi, British UK King's Land Sovereign Authority jurisdiction of Rewharewha Manukau and Rogan at Auckland Awaroa Magistrate Court, Hillersville, Moriori Manukau title to New Zealand and Pacific Islands countries. Repeated facts cited here. So that's my video. I'm speaking about that. I'll have more videos, about 30 or 40 videos on this subject to wrap it up for good. There's Manahi Mohini, he's the resident apatoro or minister of the Ratna Church, and he practices his church services in the Mangungu Methodist Church. The Ratna Church came out of the Methodist Church. They go hand in hand from this date on this land that belongs to Hori Pikuri. Now, 30 videos uploaded, Tahiki Marae Hui to Paramount Chief Hori Pikuri and his son Hiramaya and father of Hori Pikuri Ramika, transfer title to Lobo Morris Baker of Baker Street. I guess the street, which is actually Tahiki Road. I gave this song called Baker Street. Okay, so here is Moira Hoffman for the evidence for you. All you people around the world, that here is Moira Hoffman, German, Russell, first immigrant to this area of Tahiki lands belonging to Hori Pikuri, Paramount Chief. She says this. First of all, thank you, John Wanawa. The Russell family loves and supports you. There. Now, that's coming from her and her family's in the Whirunaki area of Hori Pikuri, straight from Britain, straight there with the 1840 treaty signed by these wonderful people, legally the country on the land of a paramount chief to all the lands from there, stretching up to Te Reringa Wairua or Cape Reringa, all the way down to join up with Rewharewha Manukau in Auckland, Awaroa Native Magistrate Court to this Tahiki Native Magistrate Court and this Methodist Church and this mission building where they signed, the 75 chiefs signed their Treaty of Waitangi right here in British Navy jurisdiction as the legitimate partner ship of Admiralty right here, not Waitangi. That's second-hand New South Wales 1840 treaty. They picked up this title here and took it over there and then made their New South Wales Loons Land Information New Zealand titles from this main deed title of
Russell.
Hori Pikuri, transferred from his father, Ramika, who was a minister in the independent and a partnership to one Maurice Baker, or Lobo Maurice Baker. Maura is your legal partner, legitimate, authenticated document of title to the Garrick. So I'm just saying those families in Whirinaki are identifying you as the original publisher from Britain before the land titles went into New South Wales fraudulent, corrupted title, and Cook Street titles fraudulently corrupted. The Manukau title, left that the Manukau title, that's why I'm seizing Cook Street on their fact. Now, for anybody that should have come up to Tāheke Marae Hui on the 18th of November 2017 didn't come. All those descendants on that obelisk they got there offending Maurice, and none of them came to speak for their ancestor Kōri Te Kuri, because they were at the treaty settlements at Cotswold on a Friday and a Saturday, settling for their New South Wales title and the fraudulent document and the fraudulent government and the fraudulent court system and government. So that we're going to build debt them with the pound note, the Moai pound note, and against all the third party away from this area here, and the names I have on those certificates of British title deeds. Okay, so evidence of money gold title deeds. And Hori Te Kuri, British land title deeds are an original big block land all the way right through New Zealand. Those two chiefs take precedence over the 1840 Treaty of Waitangi at Mangungo Mission House. So I'm making this statement publicly on YouTube and as evidence cited fact that we have the right position of land where paramount chief to that 1834 flag has the right to use that flag for what it was meant to be, for trade, banking, commercial contracts and private business between Maurice people, Maura Hoffman, Russell, their families in this area and these paramount chiefs, and that's it. Everybody else is third party to other super Rahiri on the hill further off. That's where this obelisk of Ruka and Birch should be, over there, because they never came up to this. We was on the Tautoko radio station in Ngāpuhi and on the local news up there, Taitakaro news papers, and also on Facebook and YouTube, but nobody came to claim. So that makes Maurice Lobo Baker the incumbent chief of Hori Te Kuri's titles and all of his land. He is the incumbent chief, paramount to speak for his ancestor and Hori Te Kuri's father Rāmika and Hori Te Kuri's son Heremiah, where the transfer of title has gone from Heremiah to Lobo Maurice Baker. There, so that's what I want to tell you. I want to show you Maura Hoffman, as my friend in Rotorua. I've got videos of her in her house. She let me stay. That's Maura there, and that's me there on her side there, right? I'm right there with her. She is my friend, my best friend, and in confidence tells me everything about her ancestors, Russell's there. See, you see? This is real people. You're looking at the truth of the matter, and there I've got it right on her page, and right out in bold, King William IV commercial contract, Hori Te Kuri to Maurice Baker, British CT, certificate of title. Okay, so there's Manahi Mahini confirming that it's all true and correct. First of all, thank you, John Monoa, the Russell family's love and support. You. There we are. They're in Russell, up in Bay of Islands, but this is where the true contract was signed, with one Waitangi Treaty Grounds. It's just a token gesture, but no contract with that flag and the mast of the ship flying there. And so that mast should be up at Tahike Marae. We'll be putting the big flag up there and everything and brighten that place up to be the official land where the treaty was signed. The other one is the New South Wales, and they're getting the bill. 970 million trillion pound notes on the Queen's head, and all her descendants and iwi Māori gets the bill of 970 million trillion pound notes from me, the sheriff of the county, of this Rewharewha Manukau and the Hori Tikuri title, straight to written to Westminster. Now, nobody can go there and talk over this title and the Treaty of Waitangi document. No one really can. Okay, so that's all I want to say about that. And there's Sue Nakora here with Amora. I took that photo of them together up in Waitangi, trying to identify who's who. There's Sue Nakora there with her friend, Amora Hoffman. Sort of Russell and Sue Nakora. I took those photos of them, and we stayed together in the motel at View Bayview Motel in Paihia, up from a place over there outside of Paihia. There's more outside. I'm just trying to find some other bits. That might be interesting. That's your family. Mr. Russell himself, Lord John Russell. There we go, people. If you want the facts, there they are. It speaks for itself at Mangungu Mission House. That's the man there that lives on that land, and his descendants lives on that land in Whiramaki and has connections to that mission house. Okay? Are you satisfied now? There's no argument. And put a hope. You'll have to take the obelisk and put it on Ngāti Rahiri's Loma, the road 4 or 5 k's away from Lomo's memorial to his ancestors. That's an offensive memorial with no date on it, no reference to anything, but just a plaque of Birch and Rooker. You'll have to explain to me and Loma, because you have no say in front of him. He has the right to say, because he has the village title, and he has the native title, and the church title, and himself as a descendant of Hori Tikuri. That's it. It didn't need to be a native surname. It had to be someone who was knowledgeable, and witness of his own information. Okay? Confident witness. Competent witness of his own information. He didn't need a lawyer to gather all the information or all the titles that he got himself from the council and the Maryland court. Good for him, because I've been through it. It's my job as a native land commissioner of these chiefs and their land to check all titles. Now, all of you people on this side of the Whakamenia, according to Bundy, this doesn't apply. You only have your whakapapa. And that's not going to win over the people of New Zealand that have the laws from international. You'll have to go to the United Nations to get that, and the Law Court, and the International Court of Justice, for your whakapapa is only for you. As far as the government is concerned, in each and every country in this world, with the international law, the government rules the people, all of the people occupying the land under occupation certificate of title, that without a certificate, you can't be identified. So if you're not identified, you're just part of the trees and the bush and the dirt and the legal intent. That's about it. Because whoever comes around and talks to you, you can't put them off the land because they've got a gun to shoot. Right? That's their law. Gun or pain, rope, King Level 4, that's what it was, because I was here and she, when the people came here, landed on my beach.